So when we look at a roof, we're looking top down, and that's the way we number our purlins, right? So on this building, this is what we'd look at as the first bay, the front of the building. So here we've laid out, we have all of the P1s all the way up to the peak. Our P2s are gonna be the entire center section. And then in the back wall, we're gonna have P1s in the back bay, but they're gonna be in the opposite corner. And this isn't true on every building, but for the most part, it is. The way that purlin is marked is really important for where it goes in the building. We have a P1, we have a P2, and then down here we have a P3. If it was a number one punch, we'd only have 1 foot, 1¾-inch lap, so this set of holes would actually be down here. A number three punch is a 3 foot lap, and so our holes would be here, and a number four punch, it would actually be about here. So we have what we call our CP punch. It's just a 4x4 punch right on the end, and this is steel line. We have our end punches for the overlap, so all overlaps get bolt holes right on the end. And this is to tie back a flange brace from the other side. Same thing with this, and then two bolt holes here. Purlins always go up the rafter, or the bottom flange toes down the rafter. The P3 is the same thing as a P1, except it's reversed with the punching. If you get confused with this, the roof plan will tell you exactly what the overlap is. We have an overlap of 2 foot, 1¾. So from the end of the purlin to the center of the clip, we're 2 foot, 1¾. So you can always find that set of holes. And the same is true on the opposite side. I'm not sure if Justin can see this, but I think everybody gets it. 2 foot, 1¾ is the center line of the purlin. Our flans are not equal widths. And we do that, particularly on heavy gauge purlin, nesting them can become a little bit of a chore. We want the flanges to be as close together as possible. So here we have a thinner flange. These are 10 by 2½ Z's. Here we have 2⅛, and here we have 2⅜. That way we can flip the purlin so that we have the 2⅜ over here and the 2⅛ here. And if you have 3½-inch flanges, it's the, you know, it's the same thing. They're just a little bit wider. Here I think we're only dealing with 16 gauge because we have our purlins on 2 foot centers and we have really short bays. So I hope that helps explain punch patterns and the reason why the purlins are all numbered a lot different. And I really hope that this helps out some troubleshooting on job sites. It's a question that we answer a lot.